Welcome back. Now we will be extending the same entity relationship basics and the most important primitives will be the concepts of ER diagrams will be the concepts of ER diagrams. The items will be entities, entity sets, attributes. Only three things, not much. There will be entities, entity sets, and attributes. But when we talk about attributes, there will be simple, composite, single, multiple, null, derived, key, attribute values, value set domains, entity types, and descriptive attributes. There are different categories in the attributes, right? It is simple, composite, single, multiple, null, derived, key, attribute values, value set domain, entity types, and descriptive attributes. So these are the different categories. Every item we will discuss with an example. Now, when we are going to call it as an attribute, we define it as real world entity. It is called as a real world entity as an object. Real world entity as an object. Examples. I can say student. Now I can say classroom. Then I am going to call it as a physical classroom. Classroom is identified with a number, doors, windows, etc. So all these, they are going to be part of this entity set. Collection of these entities, it is forming the entity set. The collection of real world objects. Now it is going to form up the entity set. That is clear. Now, in the previous example, we made a student as one entity set. It is going to have student number and student name. Next, we made one more entity set that we called it as courses. In courses, we made as course ID and we made as course name. So that is also called as an entity set. So entity set, it is made up of some real world objects. That is, it can be with student, it can be with classroom. So car, truck, plane. So anything which is physical and there it is going to have some properties, there it can invoke with some methods. Those we are going to call them as an entity sets. We talk about these two. Next one. We need to describe the entities. We need to describe the entities. And how we are describing it? With properties. We are describing it with some properties. So, what will be those properties means? They can be simple, composite, single, multiple, that we will be talking about. Right? Now, I need to describe the entity set. I need to mention, I need to highlight the entity set. How I can identify or highlight the entity set? set, it is nothing but describing it. So I need to highlight what are its properties. Properties, they are with data types, they are with metadata, etc. So we are describing the entity set, we are describing the entities. For that we need some attributes. Now let us look into the first one called as single attribute. The very first one we are going to call it as single attribute. We are going to call it as single attribute. First one, single attribute. It can't be decomposed, right? An attribute which cannot be decomposed and it is unique and it is going to be identified unique, that you can say it is atomic. It is going to be atomic, then we are going to call it as single atom. Example, I can say Aadhaar card number. I can call it as Aadhaar card number. You can't decompose it. It is a complete number, it is a 12-digit number, that's all. You can't decompose it, you can't break it up. So if I'm going to call it as a number, yes, that number you are going to. Similarly, prime number. Similarly, prime number or your register number. So these items we are going to call it as simple attributes. We are going to call it as, I just mentioned here as simple, that is simple attributes. We call it as simple attributes, and I will give the same definition for the single attributes that we will be talking about. So it cannot be decomposed, it is unique or atomic. Examples, Aadhaar card number, prime number, or some register number. That's all. Next one, composite attributes. When we are going to call it as a composite, it is combination of two or more attributes. It is going to be combination of two or more attributes. We are going to call that word as a composite attribute. Examples, student name. Example, student name. How it can be composed? Last name or surname followed by first name followed by middle name. Okay? If I want to give a student name, I should consider last name, first name and middle name. Until I don't take up the last name, first name and middle name, I can't build a student name, and therefore a composite attribute is an attribute which it is going to take up combination of two or more attributes. It is going to derive it for composite attribute. Next one. Single value attributes. Next one was single value attributes. It is an equivalent to simple attribute, and it is going to have a unique value. It is going to have a unique value. Example, I can give the same other card number, or it can be some student. It can be a student name. Sorry, it can be a student number, nor it can be an other card number. Single value is going to be given into it. So it is equivalent to some simple attribute. We call them as single value attribute. We can call that as a single value attribute. Next one was multiple valued attribute. Multiple valued attribute. So it is going to have support decomposition. That is, I can have a name with last name, and I can have a name with first name. I can have a name with last name and first name. This is part one and this is part two. This is field one and field two are there. So we are going to say it is a multiple value attributes. We are going to mention it as multiple value attributes. So in multiple value attributes, it does have last name and first name. To get a single name, we need to decompose. We need to merge the two decomposed values to get a single relation. So we say it is going to be called it as multiple value attributes. After this, simple, single, multiple, we have null attributes. We are going to have null attributes. If we are going to use null into the relation, if we are going to use a value called as a null, an empty location, to build a relationship, then we are going to call that one as null attributes. So in null attributes, we will use the blank space. We will use the empty space, or we are going to use the blank space to build a relationship. Then we are going to say it as null attribute. In key constraints, in key constraints, we have three derivatives. The first derivative was null, the second derivative was not null, and third derivative was unique. When I can say blood group, I have a table called as student, then I have a field called as blood group, and I am going to declare it as some var char of 3. Now I have a table called as student, and in this I am going to have blood group. Now if it is like this, assume 565 knows her blood group A, 566 doesn't know her blood group, so it is null. 567 knows her blood group, it is O positive. And 568 doesn't know her blood group, again it is null. So putting this null here, putting the empty space here, we are going to call it as not, we are going to call it as null attribute. Second, I will allow in my relation, in my table, I will allow null value only once. I will allow null value only once. It cannot be null. Not null, not null. There should not be any null value, but I can consider it only for once. So here I am going to feed out some B. Now we derive it as some null. When I am going to mention it as unique, when I am going to mention it as unique, there is no null value, purely not null. That means even 566 should have some value. Even 566 do, the attribute should have some value. Empty space, null, nothing will be considered when we are going to say this is a unique. So A is occurred for 1, O is occurred for 1, O plus is occurred for B, sorry, occurred for once, A is, B is occurred for once. Assume B repeats. Assume B is going to repeat. Will unique accept? Will unique accept? Answer is no. If B repeats, if B is going to repeat, now B will not be accepted. If I am going to plus, B plus, okay, again it is going to accept. So unique, it will have only one occurrence. It is going to have only one occurrence. In the entire earth, only one Aadhaar card will be there. In the entire earth, only one email will be there. In the entire earth, only one mobile number will be there. So these entities are called as unique items. So unique, it will allow only one occurrence. It is going to allow only one occurrence. Then we we are going to say that portrait as a unit. When I am going to see that null value, we are going to include null. When I am going to say it as not null, it will not allow the null values. It will not allow the null value. But null is an empty space ASCII code, so it takes it for only one shot. So that is all regarding the null, not null, and unique, which are going to be with this null values. Next comes the derived attribute. Next comes the derived attribute. So derived attribute, it is derived or taken from other attributes in other relations or tables. How can I get the attribute? Derived attribute means I will get the answer not from my local table, I will get it from my other tables. I will get the data from the other table, from other relations, from other tables. If I am going to get the data, then I am going to call that one as a derived attribute. So in derived attributes, the attributes are derived from multiple tables or from multiple relations. If we are going to get the data, such is called as a derived attribute. So when it is a derived attribute, assume I have student number, address, city. Student number and city. There is another table with some student here, and it is location here, pin code and city. Pin code and city. Now 565, I can write it like this. 566, I can write like this. Now assume that pin code was, city was DDM. Now I am going to say 534201, 52001. So yes, if it is like this. Now I want to say print the pin code of student number 565. This was the question asked, right? Print the pin code of 565. Is pin code available in this table? Is pin code available in student table? No. Answer is no. But how can I execute this query? I can execute this query using the concept of derived attributes. I can execute this query using the concept of derived attributes. 561, pin code I need. But pin code is not here, right? Pin code is not here, right? Pin code is in another table. So I need to link table 1 with table 2. How can I link? I can link with a concept called as derived attributes. So it is derived from attributes in another tables. So if I want to display the pin code, I have to say that select student number from student, comma, location, where, pin, where, 560, where, city is equals to city, for student number is equals to 565. If I am going to make that query execute, then only I can get this answer. Got it? So I need to say select student number comma city from student comma location where student dot city is equals to Bhimara is equals to location dot city is equals to Bhimara. Then only I will compare PVR with PVR, then I will be getting this pin. If the two names are carried, then only I am going to. So I need to derive this pin code from another table. I am going to call this as a derived action. Next one. Key attributes. Next one was key attributes. Key attributes I should get it from a minimal set of attributes. I should get this from minimal set of attributes. That means I have keys called as primary key, which is unique and not null. I am going to have a key called as unique key, which is your primary key, which is unique and not null. Now I am going to have a set of register number, mobile number and email. Okay? Now, register number is unique, mobile number is unique, email is unique. All the three are unique, but for my domain, pick the minimal key which is apt for this. First student, now the domain will be the register number, and this register number is going to be the minimal key and it is going to be called as a primary key. So that is what we are going to call it as key attribute. Right? So I do have register number, mobile number and email. We are going to call it as composite. We are going to call them as candidate keys. We are going to call them as candidate keys. This is set of minimal keys. Register number, mobile number and email. These are unique and not null. Anyone can be the primary key. In this, I am going to choose only the register number. Why are you choosing register number? For my domain, for my student base, I don't need mobile number and email. I feel that only the register number can be a unique item. So that unique item, I am going to pick it up. So that is called as key attributes. Next one was attribute values. When we are going to talk about attribute values, assume I am going to call it as gender. right?
Then male, female. Then I am going to call it as result. One pass fail. It is zero and this is one.
What is the attribute value of pass?
Zero. Is your mind in compliance?
Okay. What is the attribute value of fail?
Zero.
Zero. So putting fail as zero, putting pass as one, I am going to call this one as an attribute values. Right? In attribute value, we are going to include a value to an attribute and thereby we are going to process in a table. So such is what we are going to call it as attribute values. In attribute value, for an attribute, we are assigning a number. We are assigning a value. For example, for pass is equals to 1, fail is equals to 0. I am going to give a value and that value only I am going to put. So I am assuming in my mind that if it is 1, the attribute value is pass. If the value is printed as 0, then I am assuming 0 means fail. So putting that aspects, we are going to call it as attribute values. Next one.
Next one was value of set domain. Next one was value of set domain. Assume grades.
Assume I want to give a grade. How can I give a grade?
O, A, B, C, D, F.
If it is O grade, I can say excellent. If it is A grade, then I can say it as very good. If it is B grade, then I can call it as good. If it is C grade, I can call it as average. If it is D grade, then I can call it as poor. And if it is F grade, then I am going to call it as fail. Okay? So we are going to mention like this. Grades, O indicates excellent, B indicates very good. A indicates very good, B indicates good, C indicates average, F indicates fail. Now, value set domains. Now, I am going to give a value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am going to give a value between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, domain values. What is the domain values? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? If I am going to give 6, error will come. If I am going to give 2, then it is accept. Then it is accept and it has to display. Very good. What is this? This is called as value or set domain. Grades 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am going to give a domain value that is between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I type 6, I should get an error. If I type 1, 2, 5, then you should accept it and you should give a very good. So that is what we call it as a value set domain. Next one was entity type. that we have entity type. Now, designation. Designation. What is designation in this college? I can call it as professor. Then I can call it as associate professor. Now I can call it as assistant professor. Now, what is the entity? Designation. Entity was designation. In designation, again I have class 1, I have class 2 and class 3. I have class 1 and class 2 and class 3. These items I am going to call them as entity types. So designation entity type, it can be professor, it can be associate professor, or it can be assistant professor. I am going to mention that type with the character types. So that is what I am going to call it as entity types. Next one. Descriptive add. After this, we are going to call it as descriptive attribute. So, in descriptive attribute, assume I have an employee database. Assume I have a department database. And I am going to have working relation. I am going to have working relation. So from to. This is an employee name. He works from and he works to in a department. Right? Assume I am a faculty. From this time to this time, he is going to work in this department. Now, I get the relationship in relationship. I am going to have description here. I am going to have a description at the relationship. In the relationship, I am going to make a description from and to. We are going to call this attribute as a descriptive attribute. So, in today's class, we talked about different types of attributes: simple, single, multivariate, multiple, followed by null, derived, key, attribute key, value set domain, entity type, and descriptive. Right? This is all for today. Thank you.